when you watch or spend time watching testimonies, I think it's instructive not only for Holocaust deniers. It would be pretty hard to stay a denier if you watched a testimony, but also the amount of vigilance for the rest of us, because you may not be a Holocaust denier, you know the Holocaust existed, but by watching testimony, you get this other feeling inside of you of making sure that Holocaust denial is just not accepted, because you, now you want to do something about it when you hear it instead of just being passive. And I think the fear that's, I think, starting to build in our society has to do with people being afraid to step up and being afraid to do what their conscience is telling them to do.
Our collection contains testimonies of survivors, but it also contains testimonies of witnesses. So liberators, for instance, and I know you said Pittsburgh, but I'm thinking of one testimony in particular that we have of an African-American liberator named Leon Bass, who's from Philly. And you know, that recording, that testimony, really, I think, shows the power of the sort of comparative moment where we have an African-American soldier going to Europe and fighting the war, helping to liberate camps, and experiencing the sort of end station of a sort of racial regime, and then returning to his home country where he can't eat or drink a cup of coffee in a restaurant because of the color of his skin. So another racial regime at home. And so I think that, you know, testimony offers a window into that type of, I think, a productive comparative understanding of what we're actually fighting against.